Hi, welcome to Homework Q&As. Today we have maintenance day here at the studio, so switching out some old pan pots for new ones to get rid of some dropout problems and stuff like that in the trusty old Harrison console. I'm going to try to answer your questions while I'm working with this to save some time today. Here we go. How about bad hi-hat bleed? When you have a drummer who played a track with their hi-hats open during very dynamic parts of a song. Had you been the producer and tracking engineer, this would not have slipped, but you're receiving these tracks to mix. Any suggestions? Phase cancellation doesn't work, compression, de-essing, nothing. The hat is just in everything and overpowering the mix. You work with bands who play a lot of thrash open hats. What's the secret?
Yeah, hi-hat bleed in the snare can be a pain in the ass for sure. And if you get tracks that are recorded like that, it's not much to do. The most effective but boring way, of course, would be sample replacement or triggering and stuff like that. But what you can do also is either use a multiband gate or split up the signal in two. You can put some really hard gating on the upper frequencies where most of the hi-hat bleed is, but you can still let the lower frequencies ring, and so you can keep the tone. Usually it sounds a bit forced, but together with room mics and stuff like that, it can be done to sound somewhat natural. But if you're going for a really punchy snare sound, like in a modern metal production, your best option is to go with sample replacement. I'm sorry. But you can also check out a cool independent company called Wilkinson. They make a plugin called Debleeder that I think is doing pretty much what I said in the first example. It splits up the signal and lets you tweak it in some ways so you can keep the tone but still get rid of some bleed. It works really good on toms and stuff like that too.
Hobo, are you being sarcastic here? Only on earbuds through a dodgy laptop out, but I'm not hearing muddy mids and harsh highs. I actually have an okay ear after many long years producing, but I never listened to metal and haven't made or listened to guitar music in about 20 years. Just trying to figure out Bagheera overall. We have next to zero cash for this little side project. Can get a Bagheera 333 and a PV412MS for $300. Looks like a good deal, but not if it sounds like beans. Opinion would be appreciated.
As I already answered in the comment sections, I haven't been listening that much to the mid frequencies, but the high frequencies are for sure really harsh in that Bagheera combo. But it's mostly due to the speakers and not so much the amp. As you can see in the video, I'm comparing the amp with the original PV6505. And it doesn't sound as good, but it sounds really good as long as you run it through a decent speaker. So if you want to save money on the amp head, you can go cheap on the amp head, but invest in a better cab with some decent speakers.
Multiband compressor, anyone?
Sure, you can get away with the multiband compression on the bass, but what you miss out then, that I tried to show in my examples, is that you can have different characteristics on the lower and higher frequencies. If you split up the signal and run the signal, the higher frequencies, for example, through a guitar amp, you get more focused distortion in the upper mids and the high end. And you can have less distortion in the low end. That's really hard to do with a multiband compressor, but for sure, if you have only recorded one signal, a multiband compressor is really handy when dealing with the bass track, so you can squeeze the lower end a little bit more than the higher end, of course.
How would you go about getting Korn's debut album bass tone or something very similar? What amp cab mics should I use? I currently have an Ibanez SR505 5-string with Bartolini active pickups tuned to A standard with heavy gauge strings and Countryman DI box.
That album for sure brings back some nice memories from my younger days for sure. Remember listening to it in my cassette freestyle and later on my CD Walkman. I have never actually recorded a bass sound like that. But you telling me your equipment lineup, I would say that's a pretty good start. Low tuning and just DI, and I guess he's playing with his fingers and slapping a little bit, and just cut out a lot of the mids. So you get the clickiness from the higher frequencies for sure, from when slapping with your thumb and thumb playing. As we just talked about, use a multiband compressor to tame the lower frequencies so you get a stable, because when you play like that, I think the low end will be a bit flubby. So it could be a really good idea to have a multiband compression for that. Ouch! Please get back in the comment sections when you've tried it out and share your experience for other people who is aiming for that specific sound. It could be really interesting.
Sounds great. What's the track you play in your videos? Presumably one of yours. I like how it sounds. Any chance of a run through or how you put it together?
I've gotten the question about the intro track many times before, and I answered before that it's just something I threw together in the first episode I made about making a small room sound bigger with the drum recording. But you have a really good suggestion there. We could actually do a mix breakdown, because someone suggested also in my video about bass sounds that a really important part is the lower mids. And that person also pointed out that my intro song lacked some lower mids in the bass, so the bass and guitar floated together a bit too much. And I actually think it's absolutely correct, so maybe I should do a remix of the intro song and make a mix breakdown of that, and I can share the multi-tracks with you guys, if you would be interested, of course. Yeah, and the last question is totally not audio-related, it's about the dog.
What breed is that awesome dog?
And the breed is a mixture of Pomeranian and Lhasa Apso. And I have never heard of either of those breeds before we got this dog. But we adopted him from a lady who couldn't keep him anymore from out of her own health issues. So he's already 3 years old when we got him. And it's absolutely amazing. You will see more of him in this channel for sure. So that's all the questions for today. Thank you so much. Please write more questions. If you look through any of my videos and you're wondering about anything, feel free to leave any questions in the comment sections, and I will try to bring them up in the Q&A sessions, because those questions really, really help, because I think the content that comes out of me just having to answer some questions, I really need to think through some stuff and put into words things that I never really thought through that much. So it helps me, and it helps me to help some of you guys, which is a perfect situation. So thank you so much for watching, and see you again next week. Bye bye. Cheers.